First of all, I would like to say Happy New Year 2021. I hope you guys have a great time, and I would like to thank MNK aka Smashit for lending me the card that I can test it out and make a video out of it. This won't be possible without your help. Thank you very much. Gloom Undernight is the all classic MVP card that is really popular. Looking at the description, it gives 40% more damage towards Holy and Shadow element, and at the same time giving another 40% damage to Angel and Demon Rays, which is like super common for endgame content. On today's video, I will show you guys what is the damage increase using this card, be in PvP or PvM. Let's get started. PvP Guillotine Cross. You can check the dummy setup yourself, but basically I'm using neutral element and just hit the dummy with my Battleground SBK TX setup, and this damage is before the SBK 30% nerf, so it will deal higher than your current SBK. And here I have hardworking Pitman to duel against the Gloom Undernight card. My SBK damage to the dummy is dealing 241k, and with the Gloom, it increased to 326k with a total increase of 35%. As for the cross impact damage, here I was using the Gloom. My damage is 532k, and after recording back to hardworking Pitman, it dealt 393k. Basically the same increase of 35%. Please note that during this test, I have 0% elemental modifier to Holy and Shadow. So what you see is pure increase from Gloom Undernight in PvP scene if the target is wearing Holy or Shadow armor. Next one is PvM Ignition Break RK. Here I'm testing together with Smashit, the owner of this MVP card, and we kinda try to find how much the damage increase would be. We were using plus 0 Luke Sutan to cancel out the Angel and Demon Rays percentage from the high refined Sutan, so in this test, there were absolutely 0% Holy or Shadow modifiers and 0% Angel and Demon percentage. Here, we are comparing the damage from Furious Ninetale to the Gloom Undernight. Smash dealt 2.37 mil using the Furious Ninetale, and when he changed to Gloom, he dealt 2.95, that means an increase of 25% damage. That is to Holy target only. If I change the target to Holy Angel target, the last damage of 2.37 mil from the Furious Ninetale increased to 3.88 mil. With a total increase of freaking 64% damage. That increase is because of the 40% to Holy and another 40% on top of it to Angel Rays. This is like the fiercest thing you can do with a Gloom Undernight. PvM Sharp Shooting Ranger. No, this is the part where things got interesting, because I used the move calculator alongside the test. Here is my gear build on the right side, and I have 0% damage to Holy element and 0% damage to Angel Rays. That means what you see in the monitor is the actual number that you get from the Gloom Undernight. Let's get it. Holy target. Of course, as the first benchmark is by using the Furious Ninetale card to Holy target. This is to emulate what would the card do if only one of the said attributes, either Holy Shadow or Angel Demon, was hit by this build. With the damage of 1 mil per sharp shooting, cause I was using Arrow of Shadow, the damage increased to 1.3 mil per sharp shooting when I was using the Gloom Undernight, a final damage increase of 31%. And the next one is Holy Angel target. This is most likely if you are in Odin 3 killing those mobs, they have Holy element and Angel Rays. This is the best scenario that Gloom card would give because of the 40% damage to Holy and 40% to Angel target. That means on top of the 40%. Here, of course, still gonna be the same damage with Ninetale card, because obviously it won't matter the racial chains nor the elemental chains. My damage increased to 1.8 mil per sharp shooting, a total goddamn increase of 80%. That is broken high, almost doubling the damage. I mean, it was so jaw-dropping when I was actually see the damage. Like, I thought when Smash was using it with his RK and dealing 64% more damage is actually high enough. And then when I switched to Ranger and the damage dealt is 80%, whoa, that's broken. But of course, this damage increase is only super specific case, which is totally different from Memory of Thanatos, for example, that can be used in almost every condition, except Monster Hunter, of course. I think the reason why Ranger has strong increase compared to Ignition Break RK lies upon this fact. Both have the same modifiers, by the way, attack percentage, crit damage percentage, and skill modifiers, but the big difference here is there is rarely a card that gives melee percentage in comparison to range percentage, and in this case, Ranger has way higher range percentage. Take this with a grain of salt, okay, because this is just my hunch. Anyway, this is a small thing that I want to add before closing the video. Basically, in terms of gear choosing or how good a MVP card perform on high-end builds, I personally categorize into these 5 levels. Min-maxing, entry MVP, good MVP, hella good MVP, and broken AF, basically the percentage on the left side. We saw how Samurai Spectre increased the damage of my PvP build by around 10 to 20% is. That means this card falls upon the good MVP card category. But this Gloom Under Night and any similar card to this like Jugolion, Boitata, Bone Detadeus, as long as they hit the both element and the race, they fall upon the category of broken AF. Kinda sure that Memory of Thanatos would sit in the same category. By the way, I'm making a new Discord channel called A Secret Society for everyone who wants to get in touch with me. So if you feel like joining my personal Discord channel, then feel free to find me on tinyurl.com/secretsociety or click the link down below. I hope that video kinda set a light on your curiosity of this card. Thanks for having me, and see you again.